Hey guys, I hope everyone is doing well. I hope that, you know, we're following the rules and we're social distancing. We're, you know, keeping safe and doing what we have to do. Before this video started, I just wanted to quickly say that I'm praying for you guys, that I hope that, you know, your families are well and things like that. But also, I was actually laying down in my bed like 2 days ago. And I wasn't thinking about anything in particular. And God came and he just told me, create a healing soup. And I'm just like, okay. I got up and I went, I got the ingredients and everything. My mom, she was recently sick. So I'm just like, okay, let me just make this for her, whatever. But then when I started thinking more of it, I'm like, okay, what's the difference with this soup than any other soup? Because I know I make like hearty soups, I make different kind of whatever. What's the difference with this one? And then I found two differences. One, all of the ingredients, they're really good for your body. They have antioxidants, they have all the vitamins, minerals that you need for energy, to repair blood cells, to just do all the things that you need to heal yourself and get better. He gave us this land and the things that are in it to kind of take care of ourselves. So that was the first thing. And then the second thing that I realized is going to be the difference is the fact that, yes, it may be something simple like making soup, but it's the obedience and the faith that's activated behind making the soup. And so I just look at this soup as a representation of God's blood, as his healing blood that he shed for us years ago. I look at it that way. When I drink it, when I give it to my mom, I'm saying that every time she sips it, that she's being healed, that, you know, the new blood cells are fighting the virus-filled ones, or, you know, just the cold or the pneumonia or whatever it is. I'm praying that, you know, that is doing a difference, and that there will be a testimony. She's not sick with COVID-19, but I feel like there's some type of other flu or something that's going around that has other people sick, and I'm just like, what's happening? So when there's sickness in the land, we have to do our part in making sure, you know, we stay in prayer, and that we check on our loved ones and we do the things that we need to do in order to get better. So I hope that this video blesses you guys. I want you guys to share it. If you are in the home with someone that's sick, go ahead and make it, pray over it, plead the blood over it, and just activate your faith in knowing that there is going to be a difference. So I just thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Genesis 1:29. And God said, see, I have given you every herb that yields seed which is on the face of all the earth, every tree whose fruit yields seed, to you it shall be for food. So to start, I add my butter and olive oil. Butter and olive oil contain fat, and fat helps you absorb the nutrients and the minerals that you actually need. So it's good to add your olive oil, which is a healthier oil, and your butter. I can't believe it's not butter. Next, I'm going to saute my onion, garlic, turmeric, and scallion. Next, I add about 8 cups of water and bring it to a boil. Then I add my chicken. And I'm gonna let the chicken cook through just a little bit before I add the remaining ingredients. Usually what I do after I add the rest of the ingredients, I let it cook down for like 5 to 10 minutes and then I taste it. You want it to still taste good. Yes, it's supposed to be super healthy, but you're not gonna wanna drink anything that tastes bad. So I do add my seasons in there and then I let it cook for about 40 minutes. Just to note, you don't have to use chicken. You can also use fish as your protein. Ezekiel 47:12. Along the bank of the river, on this side and that, will grow all kinds of trees used for food. Their leaves will not wither and their fruit will not fail. They will bear fruit every month because their waters flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit will be for food and their leaves for medicine.